Hi folks, and welcome back once more to Let's Play Dark Sun Wake of the Ravager. Today, climbing the stairs and tentatively going to a ziggurat to kill some Draxons.
Oh, they tasted real power, yet it seems not to corrupt them. I understand it not. If not power, what do they want?
Experience points, levels, new equipment, you know, typical adventure things. Anyways, there's an NPC we're supposed to talk to here. We were told to talk to a trader and ask for a jaguar cage to obtain information on how to get where we're looking for. So I don't know necessarily who we should be talking to. The only one that immediately comes to mind is this fucking rug trader. Hello!
What are you selling?
Weaver, yeah, you sell rugs and tapestries. You must know a lot about tapestries. I suppose I do. Tapestries, you know, are not always simply ornamental. Magic users often made them into portals to different lands. Though that art is seldom seen now, and what activated them is surely lost. Okay. Is it you? Buying something? Yes. What you got? No, you're just... Obsidian two-handed sword. D10 minus one. Doesn't look like obsidian to me. I mean, I suppose here we can... vendor some stuff. And that music was going hard there for a second. Holy shit. Okay, is this magical? No. 450. I mean, they're giving us pretty good rates for this stuff, considering normally vendoring items in most editions of D&D, you just get, you know, half what it's worth. Unless you've got players who want to sit there and haggle with every merchant, which is just hell. Yes, I suppose this stuff we can just vendor. 850. Why is this thing worth 30,000? It's just a shitty plus one longsword. No idea. No idea. We have a rod of dismissal. I do want to keep that. Wooden quarterstaff, plus one. This is plus one with spirit armor. And vendor this. You could. Wait, what? I couldn't sell that. Huh. Alright. Yeah, it doesn't have a price for it. That's intriguing. I assume it's probably cursed or it'll crash the game if I drop it. Interested in buying something. Do you have anything? No, you're just another random. Perhaps you'll find something you like next time. Oh, they get snarky with me when I don't buy anything from them. Not since the days of Might and Magic have I seen NPCs who get pissed when you don't buy anything from them. Let's see. I've not gotten your fear teeth. I don't suppose you have anything worth anything. Stone dagger, plus two. Really? You have a plus three and a plus two longsword. Swell, what are you offhanding? It's plus two. Okay. Fair enough. Scroll of magic missile. It feels like this dude's inventory may be changed. Since the last time we were here? Maybe not. Spellbook of Slow. No, I don't think it did. Never mind. Ignore me. Banana of Cure Disease. Okay. It was nice talking to you. Goodbye. Okay. Is it you? Can I interest you in buying something? Yes, I want everything. And yet, nothing you sell is worth anything. And how many merchants can there be? We're just going through all of them. Come examine my goods. They're the finest quality, I assure you. I am appreciative that they give all of these NPCs seemingly unique portraits. That I have to give them credit is a step up from the first game, where it was kind of just generic portraits.
I would like that. Apparently found her. I would like to buy a jaguar cage.
Rare item indeed. Almost as rare as another member of the Veiled Alliance. How is it that I can help you?
Can you help me get into the pyramid?
Not directly, but there's a Templar named Kovar, who is one of Kallak's favorites, and he undoubtedly knows how to get into the pyramid.
And where do I find him?
Lives in the townhouse on the east side of the Shadow Square. I haven't seen him for a few weeks, which is strange, but I'm sure his servant would know where he is.
The servant is dead. There was a horrible accident involving a sword and snarky attitudes.
That's most unfortunate. I can only suggest searching the house in that case. Perhaps he will turn up something.
And who is this Templar?
His name is Kovari. He is one of Kalik's warlords in charge of city defense. He was fanatically loyal to Kalik and none too happy about the new order of things.
Do you know what happened to him?
You know, people say crazy things. But a woman I know said she saw him being carried down an alley by a giant man of obsidian. Myself, I think he got a more secure offer of employment than Templar to a dead king.
All right.
Anxious to get going, are you? Well, if you find Kovar, show him these, proof of your citizenship. Oh, it's east of the market. I know exactly where his house is, because I think we beat his servant to death. Note, nothing happens. Okay, so she said an obsidian man, which specifically makes me want to check the bestiary in the monster manual to see if this has... It does, in fact, have obsidian golems. Massive statues, 12 feet tall, weighing 900 pounds. I would think that if it were 12 feet tall and made of obsidian, it would weigh substantially more than 900 pounds. But what do I know? Shape is humanoid. Heads of an obsidian golem are... Well, the hands are formed into huge fists, but they are incapable of opening. They are immune to low-level spellcasters and totally immune to preserver spells. So, Rove's offensive, anything is going to be about as effective as it is against anything else. Yeah, he was like, I think, right here. Yeah, with his lippy servant. Just had an accident. Okay, so we gotta look around, and there were consequences to our actions. Let's see, if I were something interesting hidden in this house, where would I be? Perhaps in the chest? No. Perhaps in the bookcase. So I'll find amongst the shelves filled with the same book. My patron, a Templar's Tale. Search the shelf. A stone medallion. Oh, and 5,000 experience points. Does it look like the one from Eye of the Beholder? No, it doesn't. It looks like... I mean, that, I guess. Oh, it's a key. Okay. Can I take a copy of the book? Take the book. Did we actually get it? Oh, hell yeah. Look at that. We can read. Flips to a page. My entire life is devoted to our proud and magnificent king, and it is a life well spent. King Kalik is the embodiment of what Athas requires. A strong, direct ruler who brooks no half measures in his subjects. After 1,000 years of efficient rule, one cannot argue with his success. I count myself privileged to serve him for my short lifetime, as should everyone from the basest slave to the richest noble. Yet Kalik's greatness does not end with his strength. His wisdom is boundless, as could be seen in the construction of the ziggurat. If his distractors would look beyond the immediate hardships it causes, they would realize King Kalik using the ziggurat to transform himself into the mightiest king on Athas. Soon all will kneel before my magnificent patron. On the back page, Swell notices what at first seems a water stain, but is actually a depiction of the statue of Kalik in front of the pyramid. Above the statue is a medallion with curious design, and below it is a staircase. Oh, I wonder if we're supposed to use this key on that statue. See, the problem is that I have no idea where the ziggurat is. Maybe we can go to the north. Let's find out. I have a map, kind of the areas in this game and how they attach to each other. It's in Kibitz's walkthrough. But I fear referencing it because I don't want to accidentally spoil myself on anything. So instead, we're going to just wander around confusedly, and I'm going to turn the music back on. Okay, we cannot apparently go north. What's up? Say what in the huh? We're being attacked. Chunk. Yeah, do that. I was like, I'm gonna kick the shit out of you. And then the party happens. Rove, it's one dude. What even is this? A thief. Level 12. Jumping some random assholes in Dark Sun because video games. Let's see what we have here. Target is stunned. All right, here we go. Ego Whip. I assume that failed because rope sucks, but you never know. Yeah, it failed. Because otherwise Chunk would have just turned that person into paste. Gold Leaf. Get him. Oh, that's right. She's got that mace that's got a secondary on it now. Oh yeah, that blood-curdling scream, man, that does it for me. I did not mean to do that. I just end my turn. Guard. Or just don't, just shoot him. There we go. Alright, Chunk, please, please, thank you. Or are we not done? Or are we waiting on game? Ah. There's another victim slowly entering melee range. Oh my god, they dealt damage. Chunk, come on, man. Or don't. Alright, anything? Some coins. Looks like just some bandits. Nothing worth anything here. Come on, I was gonna say there's another two piles of bodies there. Okay. God, this is so kludgy to move around in. Oh, here's the statue. Okay, I remember this. And it, look, there's a thing right there. So let's see, do I click out like this and then do this? Swell places the stone medallion in its slot on the statue. A mechanism deep inside clicks as the statue moves to reveal narrow stairs leading beneath the courtyard. Yay. Oh, somebody gained a level. I have no idea who that was. I think it was Swell. Or no, I think it was actually Chunk. I think it was Chunk because now he's got... Now he's got over 100 hit points and he was at 99 previously. All right. There we go. A plaque beneath the statue of Kallak describes his magnificent rule, though many of the words have been defaced. A narrow staircase leads down a dark tunnel. Climb down the stairs.
It seems these adventurers would overstep themselves. So much the better.
The monologuing during the loading screens is just dumb. I'm not even gonna try and excuse it. It's just dumb. Whoa, hey, what are we doing? What the hell even was that? Oh my god. All right. Oh, that's a fear. Okay, this is a fear. This is a greater fear. Hey, it's one of the things we're looking for. That sound effect is from something we've played recently. God, these things are like so ridiculously beefy. It's my understanding that if you import your party members, it doubles the hit points of basically everything. I think it's trying to fear Chunk, and that ended predictably. Chunk isn't afraid of much. Oh my god, game, look at this frame rate. Oh Jesus, they just keep spawning. Can I like close this? An outlet of some kind in the wall, okay. That tells me nothing, just that it spawns a bunch of fucking fears. Oh, they're fighting each other. I am so confused. So very, very confused. These things aren't obnoxious at all. Not in the least. Okay, she's got two fifth level spells now. That's good to know. Blood flow, why you gotta be so bad? Just so abjectly, utterly garbage. I can't even target Chunk with it for some reason. You're gonna be immune to hold person. Aid? There you go. Swell, get in there and... He can't move. There's something right there, keeping him from moving now to engage these things properly, because video games... Oh, I dropped something. What is that? I don't know what it is, but I want to pick it up. Rove, I want you to enlarge the other one. I wonder if there's an invisible one in here. Because normally Feyrs are invisible. Oh no, these are their teeth or whatever, right? That we need for the quest. That's right. Alright, fuck off. No, leave me alone. I don't wanna. God damn it. Remember, you asked for this. Give me them teeth. No, I'm gonna save though. I mean, one perk, I guess, to the view being so incredibly cramped is that it feels like a proper dungeon crawl because I have no idea where the fuck I'm going. What was that I just picked up, by the way? Is this a cork? Oh my god, no way am I intended to put a fucking cork in that hole in the wall back here. Okay. All right, beforehand, are there more of these things? Let's care. Yes, there are. Okay. So, I mean, I assume that this is, if nothing else, a place where we can just grind for experience. Okay, Rove. Put the cork in it, man. No line of sight. It'd be great if you could have line of sight and, like, actually move like I want you to, but you can't because there's something here blocking movement. What is it? I don't know. Video games. No path, even though you know this is a big open room. Video games. Chunk, you gonna attack there, buddy? Chunk. Chunk. Oh. I dare say the game locked up. Wonderful. It begins. Dark Sun Shattered Lands. Oh boy, I'm loving this. I'm glad I've been saving regularly, at the very least. All right, take this. Go back. Kill it, please. There goes Swell. Afraid. Fucking gold leaf. Really? Really? Oh my god. Swell's like, not have, go down there. Like, I'm trying to get here to do this and the game's just like, no, you can't because these things spawn endlessly and this game is shit. Eh, there we go. Problem tentatively solved. Rove, flee. Yeah, this is... Ooh. I mean, I like the environmental puzzle. That's neat. Cool, you know, endless Feyrs unless you put a cork in it. Sigh. But everything's so fucking clutchy. Were those guys? I don't know. I'm gonna take this as an extra, but I do know that there is another one. Yeah, just sit up here. That's right. No. That's right, don't be picking a fight with me. Alright. Do that. Alright. So we have various NPCs just kinda. Oh! Alright. I'm gonna save. Just in case. Okay, we're good. Alright, who are you? Man looks haggard as if he hasn't slept in weeks. Brother! Dream. Who is it? What do you want? Go away. I'm Schwell. Swell, what a perfectly lovely name, but not as lyrical as Corfelt or Puddleblum. I'm gonna write these names down. Corfelt, Puddleblum, or... what have you done with Maligali? Why have you come back so soon? Maligali. Alright.
Maligali? Who's Maligali?
You see, just a moment ago, or maybe yesterday, it all becomes one long dream, you know.
Does it have anything to do with the Feyrs?
Yes. Do you know where they come from, friend? I'll tell you, they come from nightmares. Nightmares don't fade when you wake, you know, they crawl away. They join with other nightmares, and a Feyr is spawned, and then for some reason they come here. Feyrs are one of the cooler enemies in D&D. I think in 3rd edition, they stopped calling them Feyrs. I think in 3rd edition, they basically kind of transitioned them over into the enemy that I think are called Phantom Fungus. And they're basically the same thing as Feyrs. They're just not called Feyrs anymore. But I always thought these things were really nifty.
What about the Draxons?
They treat nightmares just like they treat everything else. They kill them. Alright, you're tired. You should get some sleep. Sleep? Sleep? You mean that after months of discipline, I should give up now? For nights without end, I have talked with myself, argued with myself, paced the corridors unceasingly. I have stared at things until my eyeballs bled. I have seen waking visions worse than any nightmares. Now I have power over the Feyrs. And you think I should give it up? Never! He walks away, grumbling to himself. Alright, I'm saving again. We talk to a strange, tired man. I feel like... oh, hey. Skeleton warriors, really? That's a monster I wasn't expecting. Skeleton warriors are really nasty. These dudes normally fight with magical swords. Ninth level's actually right. I want to say these things do have 9 hit dice. As I gaze over my shoulder at my monstrous manual, so tempted to look at it. But skeleton warriors are another actually really interesting enemy. It's interesting that we're fighting them here, though. Normally, skeleton warriors are in the servitude of someone that wears their... they have, like, a circlet, a magical circlet, and if you wear it, you have control over them. But they, like, try to hunt you down and kill you, because if they get it back, they can die. Turn undead doing some fucking work. Why does everything scream? Christ. How much is that sword worth? Yeah, see, this one's only 500. That other one was worth like 35,000. No idea. But no, skeleton warrior is interesting. I'm liking... I think the first game had better sprite work than this one does. I'm not a huge fan of the monsters that they've added. That having been said, though, the bestiary is pretty nice. Like, we're seeing some things that are varied, and I enjoy that. There's a small alcove behind the grate. Perhaps someone has hidden someone in it. Will Swell look more closely? Yes. Swell pulls out an object and sets it on the ground. What do we got here? Chunk. What did you get? Scroll? One-use scroll of Cone of Cold? Yeah, that's... certainly an item, which will probably get used at some point. Oh, we have another one. But, nope. Aha, fuck you, I've got a cork somewhere in here. I love the mental image of us just plunking corks into these things. It's real dumb and it makes me smile. It's just, to me, it's a goofy old D&D-ism. I could see something in, I don't know, an old module like White Poom Mountain or something. It's like, oh, how do we solve this infinite gout of flame? Well, we have to put a cork in it, of course. That's just dumb, and I love it. Grove, buddy, I don't think you're really gonna have a lot to do here, friendo. Just, yeah, look busy. Good job, Rove. You did a point. Man, the sound design in this is about as obnoxious as it is in, Eye of the Beholder 3. Somebody mentioned in the comments that they wondered if this ran like Eye of the Beholder 3 on Aesop, which was just a terribly kludgy, slow fucking engine. And it feels like it would make so much sense. No path. You guys, we have no path through this clearly open room to get over there. Why? I don't know. Video games. It's like you look at the map, it looks pretty open to me, but what do I know? Okay. Oh, this is trouble. All right, let's backtrack. There seems to be, wait. So we can't actually get into this area because it's like on the other side of this, but how the hell do we get over there? Okay, they've got portals. I'm sure, I was gonna say, yeah, I'm sure this is just gonna make more fears. I'm curious if there's something down here. So we're gonna fight through this horse shit and see if we can't get anything good. Go, Rove, run for it. You just end your turn there, buddy. Swell, don't you wuss out. Be brave. Oh, buddy. Just run for it. Just run for it. All right. Anything? Oh, he's the great. Firmly set in the wall will swell try to bend the bars. Yes. Snaps one bar after another out of the grate. Beyond the bars, there's a tunnel. Follow it? Yes. You're damn right he fucking bent the bars on that. Fucker's got a 20 strength score. And nobody's... So wait, we're like here on the map, but this doesn't look anywhere... Oh my god. Okay, so this just let us get back to where we came in, I think. Oh my lord, this is so fucking... Like, you guys see this, right? Like, this is where we came in. I click here on the map, and it's just like, no. No, that's nothing. That's... Oh, man. This is... Lewis! Oh, what if I, like, turn the cycles up? This is at 50,000 cycles right here. This ain't doing much. All right, let's try bending some more bars and see if we can't get anywhere. Small alcove. A skeleton warrior crouches there. All right, fair. I think it's right on top of Rove. Run away, Rove. Run away. Yeah, skeleton warriors are pretty cool. I dig on that. All right, nothing in the alcove. I guess now that we know, we can start pulling these things off the wall. See, this is interesting. This is not a disinteresting dungeon. I think that the early dungeons in the first one were better. Like, you compare this to, like, another... Oh, another cork. Hell yeah. All right. That's a good get. You compare this to, like, Dagalar's tunnels, right? In the sewers in Shattered Lands, and it's no contest. Dagalar's tunnels were, that's like such an interesting, crazy thing to throw at a first level, like, I shouldn't say first level, low level party is like your first dungeon. I don't know, nifty stuff. What is that? I think that's a fruit. Is that like a healing fruit or something? Yeah. Remove fear. Situationally useful given the fear is fearing us. Yo dog, I heard you liked fear. All right, so we have another one here. Bars, small alcove, pulls out an object. Ooh, magical sword, perhaps. Obsidian longsword, plus two, hell yeah. Yeah. Let's pass these things down. I wish I could just click on somebody's portrait to hand them things instead of having to flip inventories, but whatever. Plus three, plus two. This is probably a better weapon than this dagger. Losing a point to hit, but the average damage is going to be much higher. Yeah. Nice! I'll take it. And, alright, we have a camp, so we're gonna come and we're gonna rest. We're gonna rest, eventually. Here we go, we have this, we have the other cork. And we're at 30 minutes, so I think I'm gonna go ahead and call it here. So as usual, folks, thank you for watching, I hope you had a good time. I will see you next time. We're in... I figure we're probably gonna get into the central area and go into the ziggurat and probably murder the shit out of all of these guys. It'll be a good time. Until then... Hey, you made it to the end. Nice. If you had a good time, check out one of these other series, see if you like them. Drop a like, comment, or subscribe if you'd like to support the channel, via the machine and all that. As always, thanks for watching!